It was a grand and elaborate funeral for Vaclav Havel. The St. Wenceslas choir sang inside St. Vitus Cathedral, and dignitaries from around the world attended to pay their final respects, included Bill and Hillary Clinton, British Prime Minister David Cameron, French President Nicolas Sarkozy, and former Secretary of State Madeleine Albright, who of course was born in Prague, and she spoke at the funeral in Czech. She worked with Havel very closely when she was in office. Now, while all that was happening inside the cathedral, outside, hundreds of people came into the courtyard inside Prague Castle and outside, watching the ceremonies on large TV screens, watching in respectful silence. Families brought their children, and it wasn't just people from across the Czech Republic that came here, but also people from outside. We met one man from Holland who came, who said he wanted to come during the Velvet Revolution in 1989, but he couldn't. But he came instead for Havel's funeral. Now, we had the opportunity to speak with Jerzy Pehe. He was the former political advisor to Vaclav Havel. And we asked him how he thought Havel would be remembered.
Mr. Havel was really a politician who wasn't a politician. He was catapulted into politics by his story. He was in prison just a few months before becoming the president of the country. And I think that even throughout his presidency, he was basically a dissident politician who liked to do things in a different way than other politicians. He was an artist. He wrote his own speeches, and he always conceived them as essays, philosophical essays. To work with him was a joy, because he was he had a good sense of humor, he was very intelligent, he was a great man, and in fact, I will remember him not for his political achievements, but for his personality, because to be around him was simply inspiring.
A very sad day for the Czech Republic, but a fond farewell for Václav Havel. Antika Schubert, CNN, Prague.